for the entire month of August, I have to keep this foot in this booty, which, as you can tell, I'm not really doing a very good job of that because I hate that booty. So instead of whining, I should probably just get my act together, but I want to tell you a little story about today. I decided, since I have to wear that booty for 6 weeks, that I would move as much as I could the parts of my body that I can. So today I went down to the gym and spent about 20 minutes on the rowing machine until my butt went numb. So I guess I need a better butt with more cushioning or more something. And then I was frustrated because I really was planning to try and go for an hour. And I thought, all right, you know what? Maybe I'll strap myself into the elliptical since I don't have to really lift and set my foot down each time. I could just put it there and stay in this position because I'm allowed to be on the outside of my foot and the heel, just not under those toes. And I was a little bit discouraged and feeling kind of frustrated because it's been 2 weeks now and I have 4 more weeks of that booty. And then an ad came up on that little screen, you know, that's in front of your elliptical at the gym. And it was an ad for a university, but it showed a woman who'd been in a car accident. She lost both hands, she lost both feet, and it showed her going on stage to get her degree. And I thought, you know what? I'm whining about 6 weeks of a little foot booty. I didn't lose anything. The only adaptation I'll have is that I'm out for a while, and at the end, I'll have a fused joint that doesn't really bend. You know what? In the scheme of things, that's a pretty good deal. For all those years I had playing soccer that I enjoyed, I loved soccer. So I decided to not feel sorry for myself and to try to feel more encouraged about the things that I can do. So I was proud because I managed to kick out another half an hour on the elliptical, although my heel was really tired at the end. And I also thought of a couple of friends of mine. One is Average Moms Wear Capes, Average Moms with an S, and I hope you'll go check out her blog. And the other is my friend The Misadventures of a Darwinian Fail, and hers is darwinianfail.blogspot.com. Both of those friends of mine went through a lot more than I went through, and with great, great attitudes. And I think, you know what, to me they're very inspirational, so instead of being discouraged, I felt inspired, and I got motivated, and I did all that cardio, and then I promptly came home and took a 2-hour nap. So I don't really have a moral to this story, except you can always do something. I guess that's the moral. You can always do something. And 4 weeks, 6 weeks total is a temporary thing. And what matters is your spirit and your courage. And I hope I have those two. So these are to my friends. This is Alexandra from funandfit.org.